Hello and welcome to MetFilm One, MetFilm's monthly video newsletter. I'm delighted to be co-hosting today with Chris Jensen, MA directing graduate and now MetFilm's video production executive.
That's right, yeah. Well, it's a pleasure to be here, trying something new. I'm normally behind the camera, always organising the shoots, but now I get to be in front of the camera. It's quite exciting.
It is, and Chris will be interviewing a series of MetFilm students and graduates about their recent experiences and future successes. So, the winner of last month's competition was...
Heini Milile. She is a current student, Math 09, and studying directing. Congratulations. What has she won?
She wins a £50 voucher on Amazon.
Congratulations. Spend it wisely.
If you want to win, you have to watch to the end of this video blog and send your answers to competition at metfilm.co.uk. So our first interview is with Nick Savides, who is a Netflix-credited screenwriter, a MetFilm School tutor, and, of which I'm most proud, a MetFilm School graduate. Over to you, Chris.
Thank you. And welcome back. We are here with Nick Savides. Nick, you were a BA student here at Met, is that right?
Yes, that's correct.
Yes.
Way back in BAFO 3.
BAFO 3.
Yeah.
So you were one of almost the original ones.
Almost the original ones, yeah.
And you have recently gotten your first big writing credit on a feature. It's a horror thriller called Family Blood, is that right?
Yes, that's correct.
Cool.
It's on Netflix.
It's on Netflix, streaming now.
Streaming now.
Excellent. And how did you come about getting that job as a writer?
Oh, well, it was actually... It's one of those classic things. It was actually my spec script that I developed when I was doing my master's when I was at Tisch, School of the Arts in New York. So it was originally a spec script, and then I uploaded it to a site called The Blacklist. And I got a few reads, and that's how my manager got in contact with me. And we worked on it for a bit. And he's in LA, so we were doing all these Skype conversations. Then eventually he came back to me and said, yeah, the people at Blumhouse are interested. They really want to discuss this and talk about this. And then just went from there. And then I got a lawyer, which was a bit crazy. It happened in the span of 6 months.
Okay.
For contracts to be drawn up,
right,
and then 6 months later they're rolling behind cameras, and then a year and a bit later now it's out.
It's amazing.
It was pretty quick. It was pretty crazy, but it was one of those things where I signed my contract and then that was it.
Just, and that was it.
They just took it away, and then
nice.
I think it got like a big rewrite from the director as well. But
okay.
I still get credit because it was my spec, essentially.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it's just now it's on Netflix, which is still bizarre and not quite real to me. It's,
right,
yeah.
Because you know that's sort of the biggest streaming platform, isn't it? So
yeah,
how has the reactions been from people you know now you actually you've made it?
Yeah, it's such a broad term. My people who've seen it all proud all said they think, yeah, I mean, it's a very low budget film, and they said it's okay and it's good. I haven't watched it yet because I'm one of those people who, like, I don't think I could watch it. It's like I'm like an actor who can't watch themselves back.
Cool. So, and then in terms of how quickly after you graduated from Met did you actually start writing this script? How long was
it? Oh, it was quite a while. I graduated from Met, and I started out for a contact who I met at the Met, who was now one of my best friends. He got me a job at a post-production company.
Okay.
First, when I was living in London, I was trying to work on my own specs because I needed to make money, I needed to pay rent and all that stuff. So I did that, and I realized this is not where I want to be. So I came back to the Met, came back to a few people who I know. I went to Johnny, I went to a few tutors who I'm very close with here. I said, can you help me out? And they gave me a recommendation, which then led me to study in New York at Tisch School of the Arts to
right.
do my master's. So they helped me and they pushed me to get there, essentially. And then I studied there, which was a great time. And then I came back and I developed my spec and pretty much.
It's amazing. So the Met sort of community has sort of helped you.
Oh yeah, yeah. I think absolutely. I mean, they've been a big supporter since I graduated. I mean, I always feel like I can chat to the tutors who I met here. Some of them aren't here, some of them are still here. And I always feel I can come back and talk things through with them. And the friends I met here when I was still here, are now like my friends for life, nice. Essentially. And they all do different things. They're not all writers, some are directors, some are producers, some are doing stuff. But the people I met here and are my friends for life. And right. And now I'm like a tutor here as well. Which is great. I come back and teach, and I always feel very welcome here. And
good.
Always quite passionate when I come back here. Yeah.
And so you started out with the community that helped you sort of get to where you are, but now your community and the network it just keeps expanding, and you keep bringing in new people, getting to know more people, etc.
Oh yeah. Essentially, I said it's been a really helpful support for me. Since I graduated, I think if I hadn't come to Met. I wouldn't have discovered I wanted to be a screenwriter, because at first I wanted to be a director. Mm-hmm. I had aspirations. And then I got here, and then the intensity of the course and the tutors and encouraged me maybe try writing. So I did, and I kind of fell in love with it. And then if I hadn't been here, I wouldn't have the friends I got now. And if I hadn't been here, I wouldn't have gone to Tisch in New York, and I wouldn't have... You know, I wouldn't have a film on that. I don't think so. I think it's kind of like, it was like a domino effect.
Okay.
Essentially.
And now with all these different people that you've met, are you working on anything new at the moment? Like, what's next for you?
Oh, it's a bunch of stuff. There's
bunch of stuff.
Yeah, there's like my own specs I'm working on. I'm working with someone who I met through the Met, who was a former tutor of mine. But now I consider a friend and a colleague who we're working on stories together, and we're just trying to get projects off the ground. Because it's still a tough industry.
Yeah.
And I think the more the contacts, the more friends you have, and the more collaborators you have, it just helps.
So is that sort of also, if you had to give like a sort of a piece of advice to any potential student of Met or anybody who's currently studying here, is that sort of also what you would advise them to do?
Oh yeah,
like collaborate.
I'd say collaborate, make friends, just be friendly, be open. You know, you have your specializations. I'd say to a lot of students, and like some students come here, like when I teach. I teach screenwriting mainly, but some of them, when they come in my classes, they always think, I want to be a cinematographer, I want to be a director. Mm-hmm. Or I don't really like writing, but I'd say to them, just try a bit of everything. Explore, expand your horizons, because it will make you better filmmakers, it will make you better collaborators if you know what's going on. And just make friends with people and also have a lot of patience.
Yeah.
I tell them that's a big thing, because a few students I've might come out of film school expecting straight away to be A-list.
Yeah.
For some reason, you have to have patience and perseverance. And if you work hard and you have those contacts and you take on the support on that is offered to you, then things will start to happen. It's just because it is a tough business.
Yeah.
It is a tough industry. It's making sure you have that support network and making sure you have that patience and that perseverance to keep going forward and to take that support that is offered to you and just go for it. And also, you know, be friendly and be nice.
Well, and that goes with everything, doesn't it? Always be friendly.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good. Well, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Family Blood is streaming on Netflix. Be sure to catch it.
Next up on our interview list is Jesse Quinones and Charles Scousell. This is one of those Met Film School stories that makes me most proud, where a tutor brings in his industry connections to create opportunity for one of our students, in fact, in this case, four. Over to you, Chris.
Thank you. And we're back. This time we have Jesse Quinones and Charles Scousell. Welcome.
Thank you.
You have just been collaborating on a film called No Shade, mm-hmm. and you also have a sort of interpersonal relations, because you were Charles Tutor, isn't that correct?
That's right, yeah.
Yeah, how did that come about?
So, No Shade, it's an independent feature film made by the organizers of a festival called British Urban Film Festival. and they wanted to kind of follow the format that Ava DuVernay in the States has with her company Array. So they started as a festival, but they wanted to move into production and distribution. And so this was their first feature film, and I'm a patron of the festival. So I have they were, you know, looking for a crew and cast, and they approached me and I thought, you know, Met has an amazing array of talented people. And so this was like my first place looking, and Charles was one of my best students from last year. So he's like one of the first people I asked. And he's ended up editing the film, which is an amazing accomplishment for 22 years old.
Yeah,
22 years old with his first feature film under his belt, so pretty impressive.
Absolutely. How did you find then coming on board such a big project and also working with Jesse?
Yeah, I mean, I was overjoyed. I think I was at the BSC when Jesse gave me a ring and said, got this project, which, I was previously a runner for like 2 days on the end of production, so it was very odd, but pretty cool to be there as a runner and see it, and I was kind of thinking, oh, it's... It's going to be an interesting one to cut. I wonder who's editing it. so it was a really interesting development. A really good opportunity, so I can't thank Jesse enough.
And No Shade is now doing its festival run.
Yeah, so it premiered at the British Urban Film Festival. It was the opening night film, directed by Claire Anyamosigwe, who's the also the writer, and produced also by Emmanuel Anyamosigwe. And it's now going to have a theatrical release, screening in London, Leeds, Yorkshire, all across the country. So we're very excited about it.
And so anybody watching this, where should they go to catch this as soon as possible?
So best place to look is noshadefilm.com, which is the website. It has all the information about screenings and Q&As and everything.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much for coming in, guys.
Yeah, thank you.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you.
Make sure to go watch No Shade as soon as possible.
And now over to Catherine Pierce being interviewed by Chris about her experience at Met as a post-production MA student after travelling the full length of the earth to come here.
And I am back now with Catherine Pierce. Hello.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty well, thank
you.
Yeah?
Good. You are currently a Math 09 post-production student.
Yes, I am.
But interestingly, you are also from Australia.
I am indeed. Don't hold that against me. I've travelled all this way to get here and yes, but I made it and I'm really excited that I'm here.
And you moved to London to study at Met.
I did.
Yes. All the way from Australia.
I did. A lot of people questioned why. I think I'm one of two Australian students at the school, but I was looking at a bunch of different schools and realised that I wanted to be in London because I loved it here, and Met was the one that stood out for me, that had the right course and the right location and just seemed to have that little bit of something that the other schools didn't have. So I packed up everything and moved over here.
Amazing. How have you found then the whole transitional process coming from Australia to London? How's that been?
Well, initially it was a bit difficult, I have to admit. I came from winter to winter, so there was a bit of climate control that I was not quite used to, but otherwise it's been quite good. It's, you know, there's a lot of cultural similarities and it's been quite fun. Everybody's been really supportive and really helpful. And one of the great things about Met, actually, it is a really international school. So although I'm from really, really far away, there's a lot of students that are also far from home, so we can sort of bond over that and share in our experiences.
And have you felt that has sort of also been sort of prevalent throughout your studies at Met, sort of connecting and networking with international students?
Oh, absolutely. It's everybody brings a little bit of their own culture and their own country to the different projects that we've worked on, and it's been quite fun to sort of hang out with everybody and see how they see things and watch films from different countries. And it's also kind of a bonus that when we eventually all leave Met and go traveling and make films in different countries, you know somebody that's going to be there and can show you around.
No, absolutely. But you're also about to graduate soon, aren't you?
I am, yes, a couple of months away.
Couple of months. And then what's next then for you?
Hopefully a job. My parents would really love it if I get a job, so that's the focus. I know I'm probably going to come in towards the ground level, not at the very bottom, but certainly in there, and just hopefully in a post-production house somewhere working on something exciting.
Well, amazing. I wish you all the best of luck.
Thank you.
And you can still catch Catherine around the premises. She is still here for at least a couple of months. That's it for now. Thank you.
And so to our competition of the month. But Chris, I seem to have forgotten what the question is.
You have to name five of the nearly naked men that are featured on the Swimming With Men poster. Make sure you send response into competition at metfilm.co.uk and then you can have the chance to win a £50 Amazon gift voucher.
So have a great month and we look forward to seeing you next month.